Hi guys, welcome back again to this exciting video on Matters Fitness. Kama kawaida tumewamiss. So today we have a guest on Matters Fitness and his name is
Mwakazi Fitness, all about fitness. So today I'm told to sit down and talk. I'm used to just being active and yeah. But what we are talking is very important, and our topic is why you are not losing weight.
Yeah.
Okay, so it's a very good topic.
Yeah.
And I'm happy to be on this channel.
Yeah, by the way, check out his channel, Mwakazi's Fitness, for your home routines, your workouts, those apart from, you know, for us, we do dance. For him, he does, what can we say?
Anything fitness, body toning, cardiovascular workout, neuromuscular workout, flexibility routine, plyometrics, Pilates, yoga, anything.
Zote.
Mesquia.
And you can do them right in your living room.
Yes.
That's the benefit of it. So check out his channel. Mm-hmm. So as you've heard today, we're talking about why are you not seeing results even after thinking you're doing all the right things in the way they're supposed to be done.
Mm-hmm.
So we'll be giving this in point form. So we basically have like 5 major points as to in regards to this topic.
Yes. And so disclaimer, this is what we think, how we think why you're not losing weight.
Mostly what, for me, it's experience I've had.
Oh, yeah? True.
Yeah, don't forget I have like 18 years experience.
Yes.
In this industry.
for sure.
Yes, in this industry. So in summary form, my experience.
Our experiences. So
yes.
We might not really know because some people have these predisposing factors.
Yes.
So don't take this as gospel truth. It is the truth, yes, but it doesn't apply to everyone. These are some of the reasons why you might not be losing weight even though you're doing all the right things.
It's our opinion.
Yes.
Consult your doctor before you start form of workout.
Mm-hmm.
And if you know something that we don't know, we are happy to learn.
Yes, we are.
Yes.
So
come on the comment section.
Yes.
Tell us.
Mwakazi said and Jess said and Lynette said.
Yes. So disclaimer, this is according to our opinion and our experiences. So Mwakazi, point number one, why are we not losing weight?
We talk about calorie deficit.
Okay.
Yeah.
Tell us.
Because calorie balance is very important when you are going into a journey of weight loss.
Yeah, sure.
Now, we normally say to simplify, calories in and calories out.
Yes.
So how to balance them?
Mm-hmm.
Because calories out should be more than calories in.
Mm-hmm.
Sure.
So if you guys can, there's always a way of measuring your calories.
Mm-hmm.
And we have gadgets which can also help you to measure your
calories.
Calorie intake.
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Bottom line is how much you take in should be less than how much you expend out. So your activity, that's why we have like when you're doing your workout, you can measure how much calorie you've lost.
Yeah, for sure.
Yeah. An hour of aerobics, you know how much calorie that is. An hour of yoga, you know how many calories you've burned.
Mm-hmm.
If you've walked for 20 minutes, how many calories you've burned.
Sure.
So bottom line is what you expend out, the calories you expend out, should be more than the calories you put in if you want to lose weight. So for most people normally consume around roughly an average of 2,000 kilocalories per day. Yes.
2,000.
Yeah, we don't know.
Yes.
Maybe probably you are assuming.
So from breakfast to dinner, 2,000.
And we've not factored in the so many snacks in between.
Oh.
Yeah? So yeah, an average of 1,500 to 2,000 kilocalories per day. How much do they expend out?
Very little. Considering
very little.
We are a digital
generation.
And probably you work
generation.
From home, so you're
yes.
just there sitting
exactly.
the entire day, and you woke up and ate, I don't know what and what and not.
If maybe 40 minutes of aerobics, you end up burning 800 calories.
Mm. 40 minutes of aerobics.
800
I only
calories.
Lose 800.
It depends on how impact.
Mm.
Yeah?
Oh,
the impact. Yeah.
Mm-hmm.
High impact or low impact.
Mm.
But on average, 800.
Yeah.
So you have another 700 to lose. That one you can lose by maybe when you're walking to work, when you're doing your household chores and all that.
Sure.
So by the end of the day, you have lost more calories than you have put in. So without anything else, you end up losing weight. Mm-hmm. If you do anything contrary to that, you will not lose weight. In any case, you'll continue adding weight.
And actually, the easy thing is that we even have smartphones, smart watches that track your calories, the way you're losing them during the workout. So it's easier for you to like have a way you can track everything.
Okay.
So on to our point number two.
When to eat
and
not what to eat.
Exactly. So and when to eat, it is.
Most people actually don't realize when you eat is more important than what you eat.
This
is confirmed. This is, you know, statistically like correct. It has been confirmed and it works.
Yes.
When you eat is more important than what you eat.
Mm-hmm.
Now, a study was done. A study, you know, when they do their studies, they do like on a bigger number.
Yes, so they collect
a sample size. 90% of the people who are struggling to lose weight either take little breakfast or they skip breakfast.
Yes.
They skip breakfast.
Yes.
Then they'll take average lunch. And they'll take very heavy dinner.
They pack it, African culture.
Yes, actually that's our African culture.
That's right.
Because we are in a hurry either to go to work or what. So we either take little breakfast or skip at all. And you eat lunch normal way. Then supper, you know what normally happens. You put a mountain of food that you can't even see the person on the other side.
Yes.
That's when you have time to prepare.
When you eat. Now let's change that. Let's change that into what is required. You breakfast like a king. You lunch like a queen. You dinner like a beggar. Okay?
Exactly.
So breakfasting like a king. Everything. Your breakfast should be, you know, full plate in terms of carbohydrates, proteins.
Yes.
Vitamins, full plate.
True.
Then you lunch like a queen. Queens are always picky and, you know, in small quantity. Then when it comes to dinner, you dinner like a beggar, somebody who doesn't have. And
no
mostly
food in the house.
Yes. Mostly we advised on reducing on carbohydrates at night.
Yes.
Increase so much on the vegetables and a bit of proteins. So when you eat, the advantage of eating a heavy breakfast is you start your metabolism and your metabolism remains active the whole day. When you start your metabolism, your metabolism becomes active. That's a fact. And when you eat a heavy breakfast, you start, you know, like you are loading work on the metabolism. Metabolism uses what you have consumed for fuel, our cars normally use fuel for, you know, to run it. Now metabolism, to run metabolism, it utilizes the calories. If you've taken maybe a cup of tea, milk, those are carbohydrates. They're always converted into glucose, then into glycogen. Then if nothing happens, if they're not expelled out, they're stored as fats. Slowly. You understand? So if you take something little in the morning, we're talking about carbohydrate, glucose, glycogen. The metabolism will not be active, will not have, like, you know, the urge to really work hard, because that is
very light.
And carbohydrates mostly are digested right from your mouth. That is, I think, if you can recall from so metabolism doesn't have much work to do. So it's not active. But when you have a heavy breakfast, you start your metabolism. So metabolism will use the stored glucose in your body, the glycogen, the immediately like free fatty acids. Before you become fat, the body normally has stages from glucose to glycogen to free fatty acid, now to stored fat. By the time you see someone is big, it did not come overnight. So he or she underwent that process. You had some glucose in your system, you did not expel out in terms of calorie expenditure. It was converted into glycogen. Mm-hmm. It was converted into free fatty acid. Mm-hmm. Then it was now converted into stored fat. True. Now, stored fat is a bit permanent.
Yeah.
Free fatty acid is semi-permanent.
Uh-huh.
You understand?
Yes.
So when you eat heavy in the morning, the metabolism will utilize the glucose, what you've had in the morning.
Yes.
When that one finishes, what does it use? Glucose.
Uh-huh.
Glycogen.
Yes.
If glycogen is depleted, it goes to free fatty acids. Mm-hmm. Then you have to make sure it goes to now the stored fat. It starts utilizing the stored fat for fuel, mm-hmm. for you to lose.
Right.
Yeah. And that's how like our fitness programs is well structured, mm-hmm. like that. The first 10-15 minutes is to help you, you know, yeah. lose the glucose and the glycogen.
Mm-hmm.
Now, what you do after that, that's why we take you to our HIIT, mm-hmm. high intensity interval training. To make sure now you're burning the, you know, stored fat and the free fatty acid.
Yes.
Then what you do after that now, you know, makes you really lose weight fast.
Mm-hmm.
So how you also structure, we'll get to that when now you're talking about exercise.
Okay.
So guys.
And is it safe to say, mm-hmm. in what you have said, is it safe to say, once you skip a meal, mm-hmm. is as good as, yes, you might be dieting,
mm-hmm.
but it's as good as you just storing the fats.
Yes. Because reason, you have slowed the metabolism.
Actually, yeah, sure. There was that point of starving doesn't mean that you're going to see results of losing.
The body has sensors.
So
the body has sensors.
Mm-hmm.
We have so many, we have the keto diet, we have so many diets, mm-hmm. intermittent fasting.
Yes.
But the minute I skip a meal, the body senses I am on starvation mode.
Yeah, sure. So it tries to store the energy.
Anything
that it has.
Small you consume, it stores. Because the body senses you're on starvation mode.
Very true.
So don't skip meals.
So it's a scam. If you had it anyway, it's a scam.
So then, again, on the same thing, to wind up on the same thing when you eat.
Mm-hmm.
Why do we have our dinner at 9 and you're sleeping at 10? Mm-hmm. 1 hour is not enough for you to burn the calories.
Very true. So eat as early as 7.
As early as 7, mm-hmm. if you're sleeping at 10.
Mm-hmm.
By the time you're going to sleep, you will have, you know, expelled out the calories.
Okay.
What
you know, the
eat?
Good thing, mm-hmm. I wanted to say about taking breakfast is, you know, when you've not taken breakfast and you're walking around the streets,
mm-hmm.
you always admire every street food that you're seeing out there. So you might even end up eating the wrong things. Because, you know, when you're hungry, mm-hmm. you see motora, you see chipo, you want everything.
And because the body senses you're on starvation mode, it stores.
It stores all that chipo. So, yeah.
Okay.
Yes. When you eat is more important than what you eat. If you love your chips, have them in the morning.
Yes, so by the way, you can just have them in the morning. Then by the time you're having it
in the morning.
That's a nice one. So that was our number two.
Yes.
So to our point number three, exercise.
Mm.
So exercise, type of exercises.
Types of exercise. Now, you see, when you come to the gym,
mm-hmm.
what you do determines.
Mm-hmm.
People come to the gym and they are like, you know, 40 minutes on the treadmill, just walking, catwalking, looking at recent developments and all that.
Yeah. Listening to music.
Understand?
Yes.
So all you are doing, your body is not, you know, pushed enough to start utilizing the free fatty acid for fuel.
Mm-hmm.
You're not getting to that. Actually, the best you're getting is to now to the glucose and the glycogen.
Mm-hmm.
You understand?
Mm-hmm.
So you are not burning much. Yes, you are getting fit, which is very good. Very good, you are getting fit.
Yes.
But you are not taking your metabolism to a point whereby now you are utilizing the free fatty acid and the stored fats.
Mm-hmm.
So, and you know people love the treadmills.
Mm-hmm. Of course.
Now, the rubber moves, whether you are on it or not.
Mm-hmm.
And I know so many people look on the treadmill and they see the calories being burnt. We have done this we have done practically,
mm-hmm.
like an experiment.
Yes.
Whereby nobody was on the treadmill.
Mm-hmm.
You just set time.
Mm-hmm.
You set speed and all that.
Mm-hmm.
You let it roll. Do you know it will count calories? Who is burning the calories? Yes.
I never knew about that.
Go find out.
Set
up and let it run on its own.
So meaning?
It counts the calories.
So meaning, hata wakati umesimama.
Yes. So those calories you are looking on the screen there and actually think that you've burned.
Uh-huh.
It's just an approximation of the time and the speed you put on the treadmill.
So it's only counting the rubber that has moved, not really you.
Yes, not you.
So it might not be 100%.
Why go on a treadmill yet you have fields? You can actually walk outdoor.
Yes.
And working out though, you utilize more muscles.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Actually, mm-hmm. you use more muscles when you're walking outside mm-hmm. than on the treadmill. I want to do an experiment.
Mm-hmm.
If you're watching, go 20 minutes on the treadmill at mm-hmm. whatever speed
mm-hmm.
and go in a field or anywhere and mm-hmm. walk for 20 minutes. Mm-hmm. Tell me the difference between the two.
Okay.
Yeah.
And I think the reason why outdoor is much advantageous is because the terrain is different.
Yes. At some point, it's hilly.
Yes, at some point.
You can do that on the treadmill, but you're not getting. Then I see people, they put an incline or a gradient on the treadmill.
Yes.
Then they hold the treadmill and they're leaning backwards. Where do they put, pressure on their back?
You understand? Problems.
Yeah.
They don't know that actually when you incline it, you're supposed to lean forward.
Mm-hmm.
You lean forward, you lower the center of gravity.
Yeah, actually, mm-hmm. like when you're
you do like climbing. Power walk. Mm-hmm. How do we climb mountains naturally? Mm-hmm. We lean forward
yes.
because you are lowering the center of gravity.
Mm-hmm.
But now people hold the treadmill
and
lean back. You're putting pressure on your back.
Yeah.
Okay. If you have a contrary opinion, guys, come on the comment section. This is an interaction. Mm-hmm, between, mm-hmm. It's a talk.
Let's have a talk.
We are talking with you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
You have anything to add on the exercise
part? No. I think I've learned enough actually from that.
Yes.
So just mm-hmm. jog around your area.
Yes.
Mm. Yeah, jog around your area. It's way better.
So also the exercise. And use less.
The exercise you are doing should be yes. The kind of workouts you're doing.
Okay, so that was our point number three. So point number four.
Point number four.
Yes.
Body type.
Yeah.
Okay.
So guys, it's very important before you start on any fitness program
mm-hmm.
to know your body type. Know exactly. yourself. When you know yourself and you come to the gym, or you don't have to come to the gym, whatever you are exercising, even from home,
mm-hmm.
what you do, yes, what you do, you are coming up with workouts that are good for you.
Mm.
Now, we have three major kind of body types.
Mm.
Yeah, we have the ectomorphs,
mm-hmm.
we have the mesomorphs, and we have the endomorphs.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the ectomorphs are the people we all admire. You know those skinny people, they are very, they eat anything. They can even squeeze oil and, and they're not going fat.
Yeah, they're just there.
They eat anything
mm-hmm.
and they're just, actually for them to add weight is very hard.
Mm-hmm.
And reason, you know why?
Mm-hmm.
Their metabolism is so high.
Oh.
It boils down again to metabolism.
Metabolism.
Yeah. So those are the ectomorphs,
mm-hmm.
the people we all admire.
Yeah.
Now we have the mesomorphs who are now in between. Mesomorphs are always very, they look athletic.
Mm-hmm.
You've seen these people from Western Africa. They're very athletic. Mm-hmm. Yeah? They can lose weight quickly and they can gain weight quickly.
Very quickly.
So their metabolism depends on...
It depends on what they are doing.
That I mm-hmm. gain and I also lose like
yes.
that.
Mm-hmm.
So
those are the mesomorphs.
Yeah.
They have very athletic, you know, even people mm-hmm. who run, rugby players, they're very athletic, but most of them you see them with a body.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah?
Yes.
Yes, they're very athletic.
Yes.
Yeah. So mm-hmm. those are... the mesomorphs.
Mm-hmm.
Then we have the endomorphs.
Mm-hmm.
The endomorphs are now the people we are really, most gyms are actually, you know, comprises of mostly the endomorphs.
Mm-hmm.
People who want to lose weight.
Mm-hmm.
The endomorphs are people, they are big in nature.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. And they really struggle to lose weight.
Oh.
They really, really struggle to lose weight.
Mm-hmm.
And I think this video is mostly because of the endomorphs. Why you are not losing weight.
Yeah.
And again, it boils down to metabolism.
Okay.
How slow your metabolism is. So we are talking about, we are trying to correct. Actually, you know, you can be in between.
Mm-hmm.
In between an ectomorphs and an mesomorph.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sure.
Naturally, you may not move because these are genetic.
Mm-hmm.
These are genetic. Mm-hmm. So you may not move so much from the ectomorphs to the endomorphs.
Mm-hmm.
But you can always change.
Okay.
From being an ectomorph to being a mesomorph. And you can change from being a mesomorph to being
an
endomorph.
Okay.
That depends on what you are doing.
Mm-hmm.
Bottom line, the common denominator, metabolism.
Understand that.
Mm-hmm.
Understand? Yes. Okay?
And don't compare yourself to another person.
Do not, because...
Because if you understand about the ectomorphs, so mm-hmm. you won't... You will ensure that your eating habits are not like... the ectoones, yes. Because they will mislead you. Yes. Yeah.
Okay. So know yourself, understand your body type. Mm-hmm. Ectomorphs or mesomorphs or endomorphs. Mm-hmm. We'll talk. Yeah. We'll go into details next time when we are invited. Yeah.
Me, you know, you are
mesomorph.
And you?
I think I'm an endo.
Endo.
You're an endo.
Yes. Hey, huh? I eat anything, but I have never changed.
Ecto.
So you are ecto?
Yes. I eat anything and everything, but I've still maintained this weight. I have been 50 kg since.
We need to put you on a sumo wrestler.
But I had this. There are these people who look skinny, but at some point of their lives, they end up.
Ah,
so are those fake still, ectomorphs, or they never understood their body types, or they were,
metabolism changes. Metabolism changes. Metabolism can change after you give birth.
Oh. And now finally to our last point, why we are not losing weight, the BMI myth.
BMI myth.
Yeah.
And like it's a discussion we've been having with doctors, and everybody's right on, you know, according to what they believe.
Yes.
But it's also good to sensitize our people on mostly the BMI. Because, you see, the BMI is a relationship between height and weight.
And weight.
Does it factor in your body fat percentage?
Not.
No. Mm-hmm. Like I say, I've been training, so at least I can convert my fat into muscles.
Mm-hmm.
So if I go on the weighing scale like now, it will say, and I gauge it on the BMI, it will say I am obese. Because my height is constant, but my weight has increased because of the muscles.
True.
Yeah. The more you exercise, the more you reduce fat, and you're adding muscles. So however small the muscle you put in your body, it always weighs heavier than the fat. So when people start exercising, they start now, you know, reducing on the fat, and adding some nice small muscle in their system. So what happens, that small muscle they've put will always weigh heavier than the fat they have reduced. So when they go on the weighing scale, two things will happen. Either the weight will have stagnated or the weight will have gone up. And they become discouraged. They're like, I've been exercising, I'm not losing weight. Yeah. So they need to understand BMI. When you start working out, let's forget about BMI. Yeah, because it's only an indication. It's only about your height and your weight.
Yes.
But let's concentrate more on the body fat percentage. And nowadays we have so many things. You have the caliper, whereby you can measure your body fat. We have so many sophisticated gadgets. You can measure your own body fat. Yeah. So at least you get, if you see, you can be 70 kilos and she's 70 kilos. But she's 40% fat, you are 20% fat.
Ah.
Both of you go on the weighing scale, you'll have the same BMI results. Yet you are 40% fat, she's 20% fat. You understand?
Yeah, sure.
So we try to demystify the issue of BMI. Let's not gauge it more when now we are referring to exercise. You can gauge it when you're going to hospital or not platforms, but when it comes to exercise, let's forget about BMI, because the more you're exercising, the more you're reducing on the fat in your system, and the more you are
adding
muscle. And not big muscle, smaller muscle, but they always weigh heavier than the fat. You understand why we don't like gauging our progress on the weighing scale? But it's important to gauge your progress on how small you are getting. Yeah, that's why we like tape measure. Yeah, take your arms measurement, your bust measurement, upper tummy, lower tummy, your hips, your thighs. Take all those measurements and write somewhere when you're starting exercise. After 1 month or 2 months now, you measure again. Yeah, your target should be to go down maybe a cloth size. If you're size 16, you target to get to size 14. If you're 14, you go to 12. If you're 12, you go to 10. That should be your gauge. Your measurement, how small you are getting, not on the weighing scale, how heavy you are getting. You understand?
Yes.
So, and that's gospel according to me.
Knowledge is power.
Yes.
The more you know, the more you get to understand how things work.
Yes. Sure. Guys, I hope you've learned a lot. I have personally, especially on the BMI, I didn't know it's a myth, But thank you for educating us, Mwakazi. So if you have not seen his channel, go to his channel. Is Mwakazi's fitness channel.
Yes,
on YouTube. Mm-hmm. You can get anything there, from yoga, weight training, calisthenics, anything that you want in matters fitness. You can go train with him. And the good thing about his channel, he does them from home. So you can you do them from the comfort.
And you don't need sophisticated equipment.
Yes.
If you don't have the dumbbells, you can use some water bottles.
Mm-hmm.
We do the same workout. So whether you're using the weight, whether you're using the water bottles, I'll give you workouts which you can, you know, that cuts across.
Okay.
Yes. And subscribing is free, guys.
Yes.
Very free.
Yes.
And I know sometimes people forget to subscribe. So come on, Lisa, how please.
Yes.
Go and hit
you the start by, you know, the little you can do is just thumbs up.
Yes.
Thumbs up. Subscribe, turn on the post notification bell so that any, and I'm talking also for their channel as well, but any video they come up with, you are the first person to know.
Okay,
true. And so, that's it from us. So until next time.